This bucket represents your heart. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to keep adding different things into your heart. If the bucket leaks, it means that your heart is not satisfied. But if whatever I add into this bucket remains in the bucket, it stays there, that means we have found the secret to happiness. So you're ready for it? Do you want to know what the true meaning of happiness is? Well, stick around to the end of this video because this bucket might just teach you a lesson or two. The rapper Drake once said, "Live for today, plan for tomorrow, but party tonight, party tonight." And many people spend their whole lives living for the weekend. So let's see if Drake was right. Let's see if parties really do lead to lasting happiness. Let's add some alcohol to this party. When I was at university, my life was like this bucket of water with holes at the bottom of it. I kept topping it up with alcohol, with cannabis, with girls, but it just kept seeping out of the bottom. Why? Because those pleasures are temporary. And mark my words, friends, there is a price to pay if you live on Pleasure Island. Peter Pan always has to grow up. Now, many people think, if I get rich, if I get famous, if I make lots and lots of money, then I'll be happy. So let's find out if money really does bring lasting happiness. You see, you know as well as I do, some of the richest people in the world have also been some of the most miserable people in the world. Jim Carrey himself said, "I wish that everyone could be rich and famous, so they'd find out it wasn't the answer to anything at all." But I know exactly what you're thinking. You're thinking, "Joe, so far you've been very superficial. Personally, I love to live for my family. That's what gives me meaning and purpose, spending time with my children." And as a family man myself, I've got to admit, you've got a point there. There is nothing better than a day out with your children, just spending time with your wife and kids. It's wonderful, isn't it? But let's find out if it really is the true secret to happiness. Well, as we can see, the bucket is still leaking. Did you know there is something even better than family that I'm about to tell you about right now? So tell us, Joe, what is the secret to happiness? Well, there's one more thing we haven't tried, and it's called the living water. One day, Jesus met a woman at a well. And this woman would put Elizabeth Taylor to shame. She'd had 5 marriages. She'd searched for happiness in all the wrong places. So what did Jesus say to her? He was weary, he was tired from his journey. We see the humanity of Jesus Christ very clearly in this scene. He said, "Give me a drink." The woman responded by saying, "The well is deep." My dear friends, the well is deep. There is an aching hole in the human heart that all the money, all the success, all the pleasures of this world simply cannot fill. So what did Jesus respond by saying? Jesus answered and said to her, "Whoever drinks of this water will thirst again, but whoever drinks of the water that I shall give him will never thirst, but the water that I shall give him will become in him a fountain of water springing up into everlasting life." May I ask you a personal question? Are you thirsty? Have you scaled this earth? Have you looked in all kinds of places, trying to find some meaning, trying to find some kind of purpose? But every time you go to these things, they leave you more and more empty. Let me put it another way to you. Imagine now I have some kind of superpower and I can make you the king, the queen, and you could have everything you ever wanted. Would it make you happy? Over to you. If the answer's no, then why do you keep chasing after these things? After knowledge, after power, after money, after pleasure? Why do you chase these things when you know they do not make you happy? Do you know what breaks my heart? I know right now there will be someone watching this video and you won't even take anything that I say into consideration. You'll just completely dismiss the message without giving it a second thought. The Bible says, "Oh, taste and see that the Lord is good." But some of you, you're not even willing to take just one bite. Well, if that is you, can I just say this? God is good. And even though you've spent your whole life running from this wonderful God who loves you, who's given you breath in your lungs, even though you've spent your whole life rebelling against the God who is keeping you alive right now, he still loves you. The Bible says that he knows the very number of hairs that are on your head. He knows your fears, he knows your anxieties, he knows what you enjoy and he cares about you deeply. My dear friends, why do you reject this loving God who sent his only begotten Son to bleed and die on a cross, to die for your lies, for your blasphemy, for your pride, for your lust? He took the punishment for your sin. God prepared a sacrifice because he loves you so much. Because these sins, they block our way into getting into heaven. They separate us from the God who loves us so much, and they mean that we can never get to heaven because we're dirty, we're unclean. But when Jesus died on the cross, his blood can make us clean. His blood can wash us whiter than snow. They say that Jesus is sort of the bridge between God and man, and I think that's right. This God who was thirsty, who came in a human skin and asked that woman to give him a drink, he also was the God who rose from the dead. Now, come on guys, let's just be honest with one another. There's very few people today that we can trust. The politicians say, I'll do this, but they do the complete opposite. The sports stars are taking drugs behind the scenes to sort of enhance their performance. And even the preachers, let's be honest, it doesn't take much to find a preacher who has committed a scandal today. So we find it very hard to trust people. And any man or any woman with half a brain cell, if someone came up to you on the street and said, drink of this water and I'll give you everlasting life, you'd start to question and think, is this person trying to poison me? How can I trust this person? Well, the truth is this, we can trust Jesus because he is the only man to drink the cup of suffering. He is the only God-man who swallowed death, conquered the grave, defeated it all, and rose from the dead. And let me tell you something, if someone raises themselves back to life after dying, do you not think that person is worth listening to? I've been following Jesus Christ for 10 years in July, and he has never let me down. I failed him many times, but Jesus has never failed me. He is a man that I can put my trust in, and he's a man that you can also put your trust in. Okay, before you surrender your life to Jesus, before you become a Christian, you do need to know what you're signing up to. Jesus himself said, let any man, let any woman who wants to follow me first count the cost. There is a cost to following the Lord Jesus Christ. And in my own experience, I lost a lot when I first became a Christian. My friends didn't want anything to do with me. They said, Joe, you're now boring, you've changed. And really, they made a real mockery out of my faith in Christ. I've actually been attacked for being a Christian when I've stood up for my faith. Let's be honest, those of us who are Christians know that resisting temptation is no picnic. It can be very, very hard to battle against the flesh every single day. Being a Christian is tough, but when you know the living God and you worship him every day, then you realize what you've been created for. And I just want to tell anyone who's not drank from that living water, drink from it, because all the cost, all the pain, it's totally worth having peace with God. And that's when you know that true happiness that God created us to find. So there's really nothing else left to say but this. Receive him right now. Turn off all of your social media and just sit in quietness now and ask God to come and save you, that you might drink of this living water. But if you are already a believer in the Lord Jesus Christ, YouTube has recommended a video just for you. Out of all the videos on my YouTube channel, YouTube says you've not watched this video yet. So let's see if the algorithm is right, and let's see if you find that video helpful. And if you haven't yet subscribed, please do click here. We'd love your friendship here at Off The Curve Ministries. God bless you all, and thank you for watching.